Hello and welcome to channel 48. My name is Buck. Thank you for tuning in. Yesterday I introduced the WinDux, the Win2X, in fact a Windows 10 kind of looking distribution to you, and I could see that it was downloaded several times already. I did not get too much test results yet. I still hope to receive them. But today I want to continue, of course, with my work. And I have for you today the iPair OS version number 2. I already posted a little preview. You could see it booting on the MacBook. And for MacBook users, you need to know that you will need an extra USB stick if you want to boot any of my distros on your MacBook. These talking about the old MacBook 1.1 and these old devices still on older versions of Mac, you know, never being updated anymore. You will have a fully updated operating system with a fully updated Firefox. And whenever the first update comes out from Firefox, you will get it immediately, because responsible for the updates is Linux Mint, the company Linux Mint. They are also, in fact, it's the operating system Linux Mint that I modded in a way for it to look like a Pear OS. That's all possible with Linux, thanks to the open source community. So thumbs up to them. I also want to say that some user said that the WinTux would bring him in a desktop with only some trash can and nothing else. Not sure if he waited a little bit longer to see if it would fully load. So I tested it again, went to the whole thing and downloaded that ISO file that I uploaded that I already had on my computer. So created a bootable USB. If you're already in Linux Mint, it's very easy. Just go to the search, type USB, and use the image writer to create your bootable USB stick. Okay? Now, maybe the guy was running it in VirtualBox, you know? My distros, the things that I create, are for real computers, not for virtual computers. So, in fact, the only thing what you should do is, if you're a Mac user, is create a bootable Transmac refit ISO USB. Okay, it's a very small file, but you will need it, so the Mac will boot from it, and then you can choose to continue with the boot in refit. And for any other x86 32-bit or even 64-bit user, simply create the bootable USB stick the way I just said, with the image writer in Linux Mint, and then just stick it into your computer and boot from it, and then the thing's gonna boot up. Check it out if everything works, Wi-Fi, etc. You know, if Wi-Fi does not work yet, probably you should do a hardware scan and see if the hardware drivers were found. And if that is the case, then in fact you don't have to worry, because then you can install it. The install procedure I'm showing in some other video below this one, some videos below this one, showing how to install Mac OS Linux on a x86 tablet. Find that video, okay, because it's important to know how to partition these drives. These drives, they, you know, I mean, the drive in your computer, you will have to partition it, create an X4, a swap file, you know, and then you can actually install it, because my distros don't contain a fully automated installer. So in fact, if you understand how to install my distros, then in fact you're kind of smarter than the people that always clicked next in these automatic installers, just because I was one of them, I know. So what is it? It's Pear OS. It's only 2 gigabytes big, so it's not a huge file, only 2 gigabytes. You can download it from my Google account, so there will be no pop-ups and banners and surveys that you will have to go through all that crap. It's not here at channel 48, you know, we're keeping it real to the people. So if you like this concept, of course start with hitting this video a like. You know, if you did not subscribe yet, subscribe to my channel. Hit that crazy little bell, that is really needed. Otherwise, you will never ever hear from me again. So, I'm gonna show you around a bit what it is. We're gonna jump into the laptop so you can get a full HD, high quality look at whatever you will be able to download and install on your older laptop. Let's get started. If you already installed the system, then this is how it's gonna look. And even though this is done on the Mac, this is not only for Mac, this is for every x86 32 bit or 64 bit device. In fact, what you're gonna look at now is the mother build. This is the mother build. So this I can change, and you know, I could make a V3 from here. You see? Because you can see that we had a little update in the pair. You see that little stripe in it there? That's a major update, ladies and gentlemen. That was a major update. Because this pair looks way better and way more professional than the previous pair. So now you're gonna get in here. Of course, I should only have to type my password. So what is my password again? Oh yeah, password is channel 48, ladies and gentlemen. You must change it for yourself. But this is the mother build, so it has in fact the same password as the clones. I must change it real fast before you guys gonna hack me. Okay, there we are. Welcome in my desktop. This is the iPair desktop, peeps. As you can see, it even has a manager. This guy here, he's the manager, and he will manage all your files. Via him, you can go through all your files. Okay, that's kind of cool, huh? So he's the manager. Of course, via the home folder, you can also go to heaven. And in fact, in Linux, it's with all the effect folders the case that you will be able to go to all the sections that you need to enter. There is something that you need to know if you're gonna install this. This folder apps, in fact, it should be a hidden folder, so you cannot move it and you cannot change it or delete it. If so, then all the icons in the docky will disappear, because it's not possible, yeah, that's what I found out, to grab an icon from here and just put it in there. That's not possible. It's not even possible to just, yeah, you can put, no, not even possible. You see, you can also not swipe anything to the desktop. So if you want something on your desktop, okay, for instance, LibreOffice, then you're gonna right mouse click it, and then you're gonna say add to desktop. Okay, so here it is on the desktop, and then you're gonna put it in the folder called apps. Okay, because that's the only way that I found out how to fill up my dock. So, and then you grab the LibreOffice and you place it into the dock, and there it is. You see, so that's how to place anything extra in the dock that you would love to see in the dock. However, if you want to delete anything out of the dock, it's just a matter of grabbing it and popping it out of the dock. Okay, so that was a little bit different from all the other distros. Under the start engine, you can see, or start menu, you can see that most icons are kind of by an inspiration of Apple, because they just make beautiful icons. And yeah, icon pack was with thanks to a friend at GitHub. Soon more information about him. And in fact, yeah, I did not want to fill this thing up full with apps. I wanted to put the mandatory apps, such as Kodi, OBS for YouTubers so they can broadcast, Rhythmbox, so you can download podcasts and also listen to the radio and at any radio station that you wish into Rhythmbox. I'm gonna make a review about that very soon. Simple screen recorder, so you can do the same thing that I'm doing right now, making a nice little video of your presentation, whatever you're showing. And of course VLC, but also Audacity. And Audacity is, I said Audacity, but it's Audacity. And Audacity is one of the best music editors ever created, and all of them are based on this, okay, in other operating systems. They all do the same thing. And here you can see all sorts of effects and things that you can do. You can import tracks, you can make a fully digital mix from several songs that you downloaded. All these things you can do in this distribution. What more can you do? Well, I told you about Kodi, and if you're lucky and you don't have the same issue with your video card, this is a Mac, remember, and when I gonna run Kodi 18, then I get into a Kodi that is booting up but will give me no text. You see that? And this is just an issue of the video card. Same thing's gonna happen if I'm gonna hit OBS. So don't get so happy yet. Probably it could be that Kodi will not work for you, but on any other system it runs just fine, because I tested this all that I'm saying already on another computer. The ISO, I created a bootable USB and I booted up another machine, i5, the ProBook from, what was it, from Dell, no? Was it Dell? HP. And yeah, in fact it's working really good and stable as well, okay? So, but you will have to find out for yourself, because I can say lots of things, but it must work for you, right? Yeah, so in fact there's not so much to show. If you want something extra, just go to the App Store, the little A here showing that this is the App Store. You can see the little A of Apple. And password for your distro will be channel 48, and mine is already changed. Okay, so whenever you're gonna install it, you're gonna change your password. This is an installed system. Just wait for it. My Mac is a little bit slow. It's warm outside. It's almost 30 degrees Celsius, so these computers are sweating at this moment, so everything takes a little bit, you know. And here you can see that we have a great app store where you can find all sorts of things, you know, great applications, really really nice applications for everyone. There's something, okay. And here you can see Spotify. You can get Spotify. And installing an app is just a matter of clicking, and you hit install, and then you can go back and say it cannot be installed. Oh no, don't need a friend. It cannot be installed. I don't know why. Trace back move. Oh, of course we are not connected to the internet, so yeah, sorry for that. But these are the things that you can install. Hey, but pretty amazing that so all this information is pre-burned into this. Fantastic. We have no internet, but we can show around the applications. You cannot actually download them. You see Gpart, that will be the first one that you need whenever you want to install this, because you will have to go ahead and create the partitions to actually, you know, get busy. So effect, yeah, wireless, I could turn it on, and then we soon should be connected. I think yes, connection established. So you will need Gparted, okay, because some people were asking me already how to install this, you know. Well, installing is not that hard, okay, but you're gonna feel way smarter than you were before you know, start, yeah, doing these things that I'm gonna show you, because that's exactly the way I feel about myself. and creating one after the other, one more beautiful than the other. And I'm still not out of inspiration. So, what were we saying that we wanted to do? G-parted. So, if you look for something, just type whatever you're looking for, and there it is, G-parted. And you will have to put in your password, and the password for the first time that you're gonna do this will be channel 48 without capitals. Okay, so here you can see two locked systems. That's because, you know, I'm creating several distros on one device, so I can do more work, you understand? So I'm even gonna create a third disco or maybe even a fourth disco on this machine, and then you're gonna get these kinds of things. You see, this is the first partition that was created ever. It was a little bit bigger, of course. It got divided because of the second install that I did of Linux Mint, actual Linux Mint. That is the mother operating system of this all that you're seeing. LTS, long term supported, you know, fully updated by them. It's just like Lineage OS, a fantastic company. So yeah, so these two we're not gonna look at, but in fact, the first time when you're gonna do this, you're gonna create one partition. Yeah, one partition minus the amount of RAM that you have. So for instance, you're first gonna delete all the partitions, hit delete, delete, and then you confirm here to delete them all, and then you're gonna have an empty partition, and then you're gonna say new, you know, and in the box that will open, if you're gonna say edit, I cannot say new here, otherwise I would show it to you. You will be able to see, you're gonna see some numbers, and one will have zero, and whenever you're gonna slide the back a little bit, you're gonna see that these numbers will go up, and the numbers should go up to the amount of RAM that you have. So if you have 2 gigabytes of RAM, it should go up to 2000, you know, 4 gigabyte, 4000, 8 gigabyte, 8000. So you're gonna get two partitions. One will be the X4, and the second one you're gonna create a swap partition from it, okay, that has the size of the RAM that is in the machine that is gonna run the distribution, okay. So when you did that, you're gonna confirm. So one will be X4, the other one will be swap. You see that? Should have a red color, blue color there. You see that? X4 and a swap. So don't get confused about all these. And the 1 megabyte that you see here, the BIOS grub, that has to do with that this is a Mac. You will not have that in a normal x86 device. You're not gonna have that, but this is a Mac, so I'm cheating the Mac so it can, you know, install this all what I'm doing, okay. But that is not for you. If you don't have a Mac, you shouldn't worry about that. And then when you did that all, you're gonna go back here into your system, and then you're gonna type system back here, see that? And again, you're gonna have to log in with your password, and then you're gonna select live system create, okay. No, you system install, okay. You're gonna give it a name, or Mac, or no, you should call it iPair Book. That's how you should call it. And then username, don't make it too difficult, because you might forget. Just say iPair, okay. Password, a password that you can remember, and a host name, just call it PairBook. Will look really nice, okay. In certain sections you're gonna see that name will pop up and it will look nice, and then you're gonna hit next, okay. So you created two partitions. You created the dev. Let's just take these two partitions here at the bottom. Let's take them for an example. So you're gonna see the total space of your hard drive, and you're gonna see the SDA1 and the SDA2. In this case, it's SDA4 and SDA3. Don't worry about that. You're gonna see two partitions. The biggest one The biggest one, you're gonna mount it as root. That's a little stripe. You see that stripe there? You mount it as root and you make sure that it's set to X4 and then you hit that little arrow there. The second one, you're gonna select mount point swap. Okay, it's already a swap file, but you're gonna just select swap and then you're gonna give it a Roger D there. Then you will have to select this little thingy saying transfer user configuration data files. If you don't select this, then this all that you're doing will not work. Okay, I cannot hit next because I did not fix my partitions to get to the next screen. But if you did this all, then you will be able to go to the next screen. Okay, and then just hit install and then the system will be installed in a wink. And then you're gonna have this, and probably when you're gonna boot into the desktop for the first time, probably this icon here will be missing. You know, this will show Linux Mint. As I already said at the beginning of the video, right mouse click, configure, and go here where you see the Mint icon, click it, go to the home folder, and I have that little pair logo for you up there. So it's a matter of you setting up your system. You have to do the little fixes, right? So that's it. Don't forget about the apps that I told you about. You cannot just simply slide and put the app into the dock. You really have to right mouse click whatever you want to put on the desktop, yeah, and then add to desktop, move it to the apps folder, go in the apps folder, and then grab it from there and put it in the dock. That's how to fill up your docky. I didn't want to go for Plank because Plank is giving issues, and I just love docky. It looks good with the colors as well of the icons. It just looks perfect. So thumbs up to the developers of docky as well. Okay, cannot forget about them. So yeah, then credits to each and everyone that worked on this distribution of Linux Mint. It's 18.2, I think, LTS, and I think it's very stable. It looks very beautiful thanks to the makeover. Yeah, in fact the Y icon pack is also very very lovely in version 19. So yeah, if you did not check that yet, you should also check out Linux Mint 19. But yeah, if you want a concept distro that was untouched, only thing that is touched, that is, yeah, the icons, they were changed, the boot animation was changed, this was modded, etc, etc, etc. But this is it, guys and girls, and yeah, senior members and senior señoritas, I hope you like it. I don't like it as usual. I love it. I have it installed on this Mac and it's not gonna leave it for now. It's gonna stay on here. But I feel a little bit sorry about Kodi. Yeah, in fact, version 17 is also not working anymore. Yeah, it used to work. I used to have Kodi on here working just perfectly fine. But yeah, updates, updates are sometimes no good. So peeps, yeah, that's it. I hope you like it. Back to the studio and enjoy your beautiful distro. Okay, that was it. I hope you liked it. It's a distribution of 2 GB that you can download. Remember to create a bootable USB stick and run it on your computer itself. Don't try to run it in VirtualBox because that probably won't work. Okay, so don't do that. But for the rest, test it out for me and see if if it's any good, if it works fine for you. It's great as a live system to just browse the internet and watch videos online, even live TV via Kodi. You could temporarily install some station and just let the thing play the TV for you. It works just fantastic. All credits for the operating system itself goes to Linux Mint. Remember that this was built on Linux Mint. As I already said, it's untouched. Only the icons, boot animation, look and feels were, you know, kind of set in a way that it kind of looks nice. That's all that it is. And Effect System Back created the distribution for me. So that is also very fantastic. So I did not develop anything in this Linux distribution that you're gonna download. Only thing that you must remember is that check out my videos how to change the boot animation back if Linux Mint with a certain update would you know change it back into Linux Mint. Simply, you know, fix it back. All the tools are in the folders, as I showed you. In the home folders you will find all the little icons and tools that you might need. Also, after the install, could be that, you know, the little pair would not be there as in the start menu. Right mouse click, properties, go ahead and change that icon that you will find in your home folder back to whatever it was. That is, of course, in this case, the pair. Well, that's it. I don't have so much more to talk about today. I want to wish you a great summer. It's very hot here, so in fact I want to, you know, chill a bit on the balcony. So I'm gonna say thank you very much for watching. Like this video if you did not already. Subscribe to my channel and see you in my next video. Yeah.